The production of BHC's virtual commencement exercises complied with all safety protocols and COVID-19 guidelines.
Your fingertips on my skin. There's nothing that I wouldn't give to keep this love alive.
Bataan Heroes College brings you the 41st Commencement Exercises. Please welcome your host, member of the High School Department faculty, Ms. Angela De La Cruz.
Good day, everyone. It is a pleasure to be part of this important event. To start, may I request everyone to please rise for the entrance of the colors, followed by the school flag and the department banners.
Bit bit watawot! No! Pasulong! Kod!
Kaliwa! 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 Kanan! Kaliwa! Kanan! Kaliwa! Kaliwa!
Mga pinuno! Bit-bit, wala! No!
Mga pinuno, kumanda sa paggunot ng kalis. Mga pinuno, kalis!
Patakdo! No!
Kaliwa, kanan! Kaliwa, kanan! Kasulong! Oh!
Kaliwa! 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 Kanan! Kaliwa! Kanan! Kaliwa! 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 Kanan! Kaliwa! Kaliwa! Kaliwa!
Thank you.
standing for the singing of our national anthem.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Kayang mag-ibig, kaya sa sinahanan, alam ng puso sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, tuyang ka ng mag-ibig, sa mandurubing, di ka pasisigil. Sa nagatakutok sa simoy at sa nanikaw pangaw, ay hinagangtula kawin sa pagkayang minamahal.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the 41st Virtual Commencement Exercises for Batch 2021.
The academic year 2020-2021 is one for the books. It will forever be marked as the year that education systems around the world rapidly transition to flexible learning. Despite the uncertainty posed by the COVID-19 pandemic, we all have exuded grit, courage, determination, flexibility, and an indomitable spirit that has allowed us to not only adapt, but to thrive in this VUCA world. These are the same values embodied by our heroes, whose legacy is a cornerstone of BHC's foundation. Your graduation may be online, but it is indeed no less important. In fact, it is even more memorable as it is unique. It marks the culmination of the first ever school year of flexible learning. You are the very first batch of BHC graduates who have surmounted the trials posed by this pandemic. And you have managed to exceed expectations, which is why you are here. From the comforts of your home, and in the company of your family, you can celebrate your achievement through this online graduation, which is a commemoration not only of your attainment, but of the whole BHC community's unwavering resolve to continue her mission of providing quality education despite overwhelming odds. This achievement includes the faculty and staff who have worked tirelessly throughout the year to ensure an enriching learning experience, putting you, the learner, at the center of the education process. This graduation also celebrates your parents who have nurtured, guided, and supported you all throughout your lives, wanting the best for you so you can be independent and substantial persons who contribute to the good of the community. Everyone who has supported you in your journey is a part of this milestone. And of course, the Almighty, who has been a constant source of strength and through whom all things are possible. As you move on to the next phase of your lives and try to find your place in the sun, always remember that you will always find a home in Bataan Heroes College, your alma mater. Congratulations to you, our dearest graduates. We are proud of you.
To give us her welcome remarks, please welcome the Executive Vice President of Bataan Heroes College, Ms. Precious Lilibeth D. Robles.
Madam President Dr. Rosalinda De Leste, school administrators, deans and heads of the various departments, faculty and staff, family and friends, and most especially to the graduating class of Bataan Heroes College. Good day. We are gathered today for a very special celebration, the culmination of our dear graduates' years of hard work. Graduation is always a day to look forward to all the possibilities ahead of us, but it is more meaningful when we look back and reminisce our journey, what you have overcome, and how far you've come. This batch has truly had a very challenging year, but Heroes, which has been founded in memory of our fallen heroes of war, reminds us that we have within us the very same virtues of perseverance and the indomitability of the human spirit. So no matter where life brings you, know that you bring with you our hopes and our faith in you. And true to your school's motto, we believe that you will be true instruments for social transformation. So in behalf of the Bataan Heroes College Administration, welcome to school year 2020-2021 commencement exercises.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Precious Lilibeth D. Robles, thank you very much.
I am privileged to call on Dr. Rosalinda Rosales de Leste, Bataan Heroes College President, for her acceptance and recognition of Batch 2020 to 2021. Her address to the graduates is most welcome. Madam President, please do the honor.
Madam President, it is my honor and distinct privilege to present to you 100 candidates for graduation from the 5-year engineering course leading to a degree in Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering, and 7 candidates from the same course leading to a degree in Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering. Likewise, my honor to present to you 21 candidates for graduation from the 4-year criminology course leading to a degree in Bachelor of Science in Criminology, and 4 candidates for graduation from the 4-year Information Technology course leading to a degree in Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. These candidates have satisfactorily completed all the academic requirements prescribed by the Commission on Higher Education and by the Bataan Heroes College.
By the authority granted to Bataan Heroes College by the Commission on Higher Education and by the power vested upon me as college president, upon the recommendation of your faculty, deans, and heads, for having completed the academic requirements of the course, I hereby confirm the graduates of Batch 2021 as worthy recipients of the academic degrees and diplomas for school year 2020-2021, with all the rights and privileges appurtenant thereto. Congratulations to all our successful graduates. Good luck, good health, and God bless.
Thank you very much, Mr. Vergara and Dr. De Leste.
Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering. Renalyn G. Abad, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Denapemia G. Abad, from Lamau, Limay, Bataan. Regina May Lourdes D. Abrera, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Sandy C. Abrera, from Balanga City, Bataan. Porfelio Jr. M. Abrigonda, son of Mr. and Mrs. Porfelio Abrigonda, from Limay, Bataan. Catherine B. Agoncillo, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Agoncillo, from Limay, Bataan. Patrick Jason M. Alejo, son of Mrs. Marilu Mina Alejo, from Abukay, Bataan. Brent Louis G. Aloro, son of Mr. and Mrs. Bernard Aloro, from Maribeles, Bataan. Diana Claire F. Angeles, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Angelo Angeles from Maribeles, Bataan. John Joseph G. Angeles, son of Mr. and Mrs. Dennis C. Angeles from Limay, Bataan. Charmaine Hannah C. Artapes, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Armando P. Artapes from Lamao, Limay, Bataan. Carl Francisco Balbuena, son of Mr. and Mrs. Alexander R. Balbuena from Lamao, Limay, Bataan. Ruth A. Bantillo, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Rudy Bantillos G. Sr. from Maribeles, Bataan. Winnie S. Barata, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Jesus Y. Barata from Pilar, Bataan. Jan C. D. Base, son of Mr. and Mrs. Placido B. Base Jr. from Maribeles, Bataan. Katrina Cassandra M. Batak, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Elmer P. Batak from Maribeles, Bataan. Diane Kimberly E. Kalimbas, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Rolando C. Kalimbas Jr. from Limay, Bataan. John Luis L. Canceran, son of Mrs. Lucy Canceran from Balanga City, Bataan. Ivan Christian S. Capulong, son of Mr. and Mrs. Alwin R. Capulong from Samal, Bataan. Arvin J. B. Castillo, son of Mr. and Mrs. Alvin R. Castillo from Limay, Bataan. R.G. P. Castro, son of Mr. and Mrs. Arvin B. Castro from Maribeles, Bataan. John Ranel A. Chua, son of Mr. and Mrs. Arnel Chua from Abukay, Bataan. Marvin E. Cortez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rizal B. A. Cortez from Limay, Bataan. Crisaldo P. Costales, son of Mr. and Mrs. Bernardo F. Costales from Orani, Bataan. Maria Jesusa D. Crisostomo, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Manuel Crisostomo from Balanga City, Bataan. Roel C. Cruz, son of Rufino Cruz from Abukay, Bataan. Joshua H. Escudio, son of Mr. and Mrs. Narciso Reyes from Limay, Bataan. Jonathan S. Dato, son of Mr. and Mrs. Molly S. Dato from Hermosa, Bataan. John Gabriel B. Guzman, son of John L. Guzman from Balanga City, Bataan. Nikki M. Desus, son of Mr. and Mrs. Alan Desus from Orion, Bataan. John Mark L. De Leon, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rodrigo De Leon from Maribeles, Bataan. John Rick L. De Villa, son of Mr. and Mrs. Sunny A. De Villa from Balanga City, Bataan. Kim Gerald C. De La Cruz, son of Mr. and Mrs. Gerardo De La Cruz from Limay, Bataan. June Maverick U. Dela, son of Mr. and Mrs. Julius Dela from Pilar, Bataan. Ian Mark M. Desamito, son of Mr. and Mrs. Orlando T. Desamito from Limay, Bataan. Roderick G. Dominguez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rodolfo F. Dominguez from Lamao, Limay, Bataan. Renzo Rafael Espiritu, son of Mr. and Mrs. Richard L. Espiritu from Lamao, Limay, Bataan. Mark Lester M. Fernando, son of Mr. and Mrs. Lamberto Fernando from Limay, Bataan. Luisa B. Garcia, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Louis C. Garcia from Balanga City, Bataan. Ray Joseph I. Garcia, son of Mr. and Mrs. Reynaldo B. Garcia from Balanga City, Bataan. Daniel R. Gonzalez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Victoriano D. Gonzalez from Limay, Bataan. Tristan Roy M. Habig, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rogelio R. Habig from Limay, Bataan. Angelo J. O. Ignacio, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rod Ignacio from Olongapo City, Bataan. Oljan S. Jimenez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Filemon L. Jimenez Jr. from Balanga City, Bataan. Jerome Wilford M. Laudato, son of Romeo, Mr. and Mrs. Romeo Laudato from Limay, Bataan. Ver Alvin T. Lingan, son of Mr. and Mrs. Nicacio A. Lingad from Balanga City, Bataan. Ramel M. Magana, son of Raul I. Magana from Mariveres, Bataan. Mark Gilson B. Mapalo, son of Mr. and Mrs. Mario B. Mapalo from Lamao, Limay, Bataan.
Senor D. Maranan, son of Mr. and Mrs. Gilbert Maranan from Limay, Bataan. Dave A. Mariano, son of Mr. and Mrs. Dennis Mariano from Balanga City, Bataan. Justin M. Martina, son of Mr. and Mrs. Resalito Martina from Mariveles, Bataan. Marlon Brando P. Mendoza, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rolando P. Mendoza from Balanga City, Bataan. Revelyn R. Morente, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Revelito M. Morente from Mariveles, Bataan. Ferbey C. Murcia, son of Mr. and Mrs. Fermin Murcia from Mariveles, Bataan. Ronel T. Narciso, son of Mr. and Mrs. Noel G. Narciso from Mariveles, Bataan. Ian M. Nastor, son of Mr. and Mrs. Felicissimo O. Nastor Jr. from Mariveles, Bataan. John Bermel B. Navarro, son of Robert Navarro from Orion, Bataan. Jobert B. Navarro, son of Mr. and Mrs. Robert Navarro from Orion, Bataan. Marty S. Navarro, son of Mr. and Mrs. Ramil Loreto Navarro from Orion, Bataan. Luke Vincent E. Nisay, son of Mr. and Mrs. Victor L. Nisay from Balanga City, Bataan. Foster G. Oscares, son of Mr. and Mrs. Carlos Oscares from Limay, Bataan. Ian Nico U. Paking, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rolito L. Paking from Lamao, Limay, Bataan. J. Justin Carlo D. Palakay, son of Mr. and Mrs. Charlie Palakay from Balanga City, Bataan. Nico Neil Andro C. Palad, son of Mr. and Mrs. Andronico K. Palad from Bagak, Bataan. Ara Jane D. Palka, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Fraser Palkat from Balanga City, Bataan. Aris Francis F. Pascual, son of Mr. and Mrs. Enaro Pascual from Binay, Bataan. Nico R. Peña Florida, son of Mr. and Mrs. Edmundo Peña Florida from Binay, Bataan. Elma D. Perpinya, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Elmer Perpinyan from Limay, Bataan. Mark Jerick G. Prado, son of Mr. and Mrs. Frederick E. Prado from Orion, Bataan. Jan Machu G. Prieto, son of Mr. and Mrs. Vicente M. Prieto from Limay, Bataan. Julian A. Reynulo, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Vicente S. Reynulo from Mariveles, Bataan. Jan Jose B. Rapista, son of Mr. and Mrs. Joven Rapista from Balanga City, Bataan. Joseph C. Roque, son of Mr. and Mrs. Joseph D. Roque from Limay, Bataan. Ronel Don I. Ruiz, son of Mr. and Mrs. Nelson Ruiz from Mariveles, Bataan. Mark Rainer G. Salvador, son of Mr. and Mrs. Oliver Salvador from Limay, Bataan. Lovely Joy M. Santos, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Alfredo M. Santos from Dinalupihan, Bataan. Sir G. Marcy Santos, son of Mr. and Mrs. Osmar M. Santos from Orion, Bataan. Jan Neil P. Sylvester, son of Eufemio Mendoza Sylvester from Pilar, Bataan. Raydel M. Sylvester, son of Mr. and Mrs. Dari C. Sylvester from Dinalupihan, Bataan. Kyle Russell P. Solomon, son of Mr. and Mrs. Emmanuel Solomon from Pilar, Bataan. Johnny Boy I. Sombilla, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jesse Sombilla from Orion, Bataan. Clint Brian Soriano, son of Mr. and Mrs. Froilan Soriano from Mariveles, Bataan. Michael Anthony C. Sobisa, son of Mr. and Mrs. Antonio L. Sobisa from Balanga City, Bataan. Nilo Talan Jr., son of Mrs. Annie Yeates from Abukay, Bataan. Christian Art V. Tolentino, son of Mr. and Mrs. Arturo M. Tolentino from Pilar, Bataan. Eugene A. Torres, son of Mr. and Mrs. Dante M. Torres from Pilar, Bataan. Jomel A. Velasco, son of Mr. and Mrs. Enrico R. Velasco from Balanga City, Bataan. Jane Chloe M. Vicente, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Roberto T. Vicente Jr. from Mariveles, Bataan. Alvin A. Vidal, son of Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Vidal from Samal, Bataan. Jan Michael D. Villafuerte, son of
Mr. and Mrs. Rodolfo R. Villacrete from Orani, Bataan. Kim P. Villaruz, son of Joel M. Villaruz from Limay, Bataan. Rosheya Romar M. Villoria, son of Mr. and Mrs. Romel Villoria from Mariveles, Bataan. MJ T. Vinson, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rodolfo B. Vinson from Samal, Bataan. Sahan Leon G. Whitehead, son of Mr. and Mrs. Barijan Whitehead from Orion, Bataan. And last but not the least, Eugene M. Yumena, son of Mr. and Mrs. Renato Yumena from Abucay, Bataan. Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering. Rolel A. Abina, son of Mr. and Mrs. Romeo Abina from Limay, Bataan. Regine G. Antones, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Reynaldo Antones from Balanga City, Bataan. Christian R. Basa, son of Augusto Basa from Limay, Bataan. Luigi C. Dimapiles, son of Mr. and Mrs. Marte Dimapiles from Limay, Bataan. J.B. O. Pamesa, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jaime Pamesa from Limay, Bataan. Dominic C. Obdin, son of Mr. and Mrs. Ariel Obdin from Abucay, Bataan. Eugene Paulo M. Reyes, son of Mr. and Mrs. Pastor Reyes Jr. from Vilar, Bataan.
Batch 2021, Bachelor of Science in Criminology. Kimberly D. Abalos, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Jeremias Abalos of Vilar, Bataan. John Lindsay B. Angeles, son of Mr. and Mrs. Alfredo Angeles of Vilar, Bataan. Jericho A. Bahado, son of Mr. and Mrs. Pedro Bahado of Mariveles, Bataan. Richard A. Banya, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rico Banya of Limay, Bataan. Raymond Jacques Milandra Broussard, son of Mr. and Mrs. Roberti Broussard, Limay, Bataan. Rosilia May M. Calma, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Nomer Davis Calma of Morong, Bataan. Arvin P. Carillo, son of Mr. and Mrs. Tommy Carillo, Mariveles, Bataan. Rinaldo P. Corpin, son of Mr. and Mrs. Remigio Corpin Jr. of Mariveles, Bataan. Michael S. Dimakulangan, son of Mr. and Mrs. Carmelo Dimakulangan of Mariveles, Bataan. Romilene Benson Fernandez, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Romel Fernandez of Balanga City, Bataan. Joseph Paclip Jeronimo, son of Mr. and Mrs. Severino Jeronimo of Lamao, Limay, Bataan. Emerson Garcia Gutierrez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Eduardo Gutierrez of Mariveles, Bataan. Simonel Castillo Labiste, daughter of Felicissimo Limosnero Labiste of Mariveles, Bataan. Welvin Andy Magnay, son of Mr. and Mrs. Wilfredo Magnay of Balanga City, Bataan. Gisa Faye Milano Mapalo, daughter of Mario Blasa Mapalo of Lamao, Limay, Bataan. Midonic George L. Mercado, son of Mr. and Mrs. June Mercado, Balanga City, Bataan. Janine Sacramento Ramos, daughter of Francisco, Mr. and Mrs. Francisco Ramos of Balanga City, Bataan. Angeline Madrid San Jose, daughter of Edgardo San Jose of Bilolo Orion, Bataan. Randy N. Solit Jr., the son of Randy Solit Sr. of Maribelis, Bataan. Eunice E. Renati, son of Mr. and Mrs. Lindo Renati of Balanga City, Bataan. And last but not the least, Harvey B. Valencia, son of Mr. and Mrs. Eduardo Valencia of Hermosa, Bataan.
Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, Mark Leo and Rosalam, son of Mrs. Angelina De Leon from Maribeles, Bataan. Rainier Jeff Quiroz, son of Mr. and Mrs. Severino A. Quiroz, Balanga City, Bataan. Micaela Shabok, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Froilan Shabok from City of Balanga. Sean Tentativa, son of Mrs. Donaline Tentativa from Maribeles, Bataan.
Congratulations to our dearest graduates and completers and to their parents and their guardians.
It is with pleasure that I call on the college president, Dr. Rosalinda Rosales de Leste, for her address to the graduates.
My sincerest congratulations to all of you, my dear graduates and completers, for having completed another challenging stage of your academic life. But most of all, my sincerest gratitude to all the parents of these graduates and completers for having greatly contributed to the accomplishments of your children by the proper guidance, support, and the many sacrifices you have done for them to achieve this far of their academic endeavors. During this time of the pandemic, our goal as educators should be to find ways to make technology and social media an avenue to make teaching and learning more efficient and effective, and not complicated if we are to maximize the potentials of every student. We fervently hope that this pandemic will be over so that we can go back to our normal way of life and for our children to go back to the classrooms. We hope to see you in person, and may the Lord and Allah protect you and keep you safe. Congratulations. Peace be with you.
Thank you, Madam, for your warm message to the graduates.
Bataan Heroes College honors and recognizes the outstanding performance of her graduates, both in academic and co-curricular accomplishments. Here are the special awards. Leadership Award. This award is given to a graduating student who has exhibited exemplary character and strong leadership skills, which have positively affected the college community through involvement in school organizations. Leadership and Service Award. Joseph P. Geronimo from BS Criminology. Geronimo was the DSG Governor of Criminal Justice Department in 2019 to 2020. He's also the outgoing DSG fourth year representative. Endeavor Award. This award is given to a graduating student who has worked his or her way through college as a working scholar in BHC. This is also given to students who worked outside the college to support their own studies. Endeavor Award from BS Criminology. Mironic George L. Mercado. Mercado is a member of the Capital Security and Intelligence Unit at the Bunker. Loyalty Award. This award is given to a student who completed 100% of his or her academic units in the college and whose parent or sibling is an alumni of the college. This award is also given to a student who has completed all his secondary education, junior high school and senior high school, and tertiary education in the college. The Loyalty Awardees from BS Mechanical Engineering. Carl F. Balbuena, Revelin R. Morente, Roniel Don I. Ruiz, John Gabriel D. de Guzman, Mark Gilson V. Mapalo, Aris Francis F. Pascual, Clint Brian Soriano, Eugene Yumena from BS Criminology, Jessa Faye V. Mapalo. Special Talent Awards. Special Talent Awards in music, sports, literary work, theater, and the arts are given to students who have shown exemplary talent which have positively affected the community. John Jose B. Rapista from BS Mechanical Engineering. Rapista served as a circulations manager and managing editor of Ang Bayani. He's also an outgoing senator of mechanical engineering. Congratulations!
Please welcome Mr. Ray Jocel Garcia from BS Mechanical Engineering in his address for and on behalf of the graduates.
Good day, class of 2021. Before I begin, I would like to give my heartfelt gratitude for giving me the opportunity to give a speech on behalf of the graduates today. Executive Vice President Ms. Precious Lilibet D. Robles, Administrative Officer Ms. Loris Fay R. Juarez, Director for Administration Mr. Wilfredo C. Aguila, Directors for Academics Mr. Arnold B. Vergara, deans, heads, faculty and staff, and to all my fellow graduates, a pleasant day to all. I want to start my speech with a word, sana. Ano nga ba ang salitang sana? S-A-N-A. For me, it is a single Tagalog word that has a very deep meaning. A single word enough to remind us all of all our missed opportunities. Sana ginalingan ko. Sana nag-review ko. Sana nakinig ako. Sana hindi ako nangopya. At sana may babalik ko pa ang oras. Today, I would like to tell you a story. A story my father would keep on telling me whenever he had a chance. The story of Intoy. Intoy was a son of land tenants and was the eldest of 9 siblings. In his early educational career, from elementary to high school, every day, Intoy would wake up 3 in the morning and would walk himself 5 kilometers to school. Before he reaches school, he would take a detour to the public market. He would sell saging masaba. If he can sell his saging masaba, he would have saging masaba for lunch and recess. After school, he would then walk another 5 kilometers to reach home. He would use a gasera, a kerosene lamp, as light source at night in order to complete his assignments. During weekends, he would tend to crops and farm animals, composed of a cow, a carabao, 3 goats, and a bunch of chicken. As he sat on his kalmata, he looked at his parents and said to himself, I don't want to be like this forever. And as years passed by, Intoy managed to graduate as valedictorian and top on almost all his subjects except one, mathematics. His college career was another labor. Due to his academic excellence during his elementary and high school days, he was accepted as a scholar in a university in Manila. This too was another struggle due to their financial situations, as his parents are only managing to make ends meet. Supplying his academic needs in Manila would be a blow to their daily expenses. Yet he convinced his parents that it would all be worth it if he would support, if they would support him until he graduates. He took up a course different from what he actually wanted. Inton took up Bachelor of Science in Industrial Technology as a scholarship requirement. He struggled into his college career. If someone would throw him candy, he would eat candy. And if someone would throw him bread, he would eat bread. With no financial assistance from his parents, Intoy had to look up for ways in order to sustain himself in Manila. He managed to take a part-time job in a machine shop, and armed with only a 0.3 technical pen, he would work on technical drawings for his other classmates. One day, Intoy had a visitor, his father. He came to check on his son. Then he asked Intoy if he would not go home as much, because if he was to go home, they would have to borrow money in order for him to return back to Manila. And a few years passed, Intoy managed to graduate college. From there on, Intoy found jobs in a local refinery. Then he went abroad, where his life made a drastic turn. From a son of a tenant to a mechanical supervisor of one of the largest refineries abroad, Intoy made it. Years ago, I would hear this story again and again from my father, not knowing who this Intoy person was. But then one day, I heard my grandmother calling out, "Intoy!" And my father responded. That was then I realized who Intoy really is. But still, I never understood the message. I was never like Intoy. I took everything for granted. And as some of you have too, I enrolled in different universities and I was always playing computer instead of attending classes. Never had a care about the tuition fee that my parents paid for my education. I felt entitled to the point that whether I would graduate or not won't be a bother because of the financial assistance my parents are able to produce. We have businesses and a farm that could well sustain our daily needs and wants. But then a tragedy struck. Within 1 month, both of my parents was taken from me, disappeared, and gone forever. At this point, as the eldest of three siblings, I knew I had to do something. I willingly sacrificed my education to look after the businesses that my parents have left behind while my other two siblings continued their studies. Then one day, while I was drinking coffee at home, I heard someone calling out, "Intoy, Intoy." That is when I recalled the story my father kept on telling me. That is where then I said to myself, "Sana, may balik ko ang oras." I wanted to make up for the lost time and opportunities that I knew was impossible. I never had been so amazed by the perseverance of a single person on wanting to change his life status that he would pierce through adversities that others greatly hindered their advances in life. Because of Intoy, his opportunities may be limited, but he managed to make the most of it. What I want to tell you, fellow graduates, that never let your situation take the most of you and hold you down. And as we part ways, as we seek our own glory, let go of all our sana, let go of regrets, and take every opportunity just like Intoy. Make the most of it. Congratulations, fellow graduates, parents, and guardians. We made it.
Thank you, Mr. Garcia, for your encouraging and inspiring message. We hope that you and your batchmates will achieve the success that you deserve. At this moment, let us pin our ears back to Mr. Wilfredo C. Aguila, Director for Administration, as he pays tribute to the members of the Faculty of Instruction and staff. Mr. Aguila, sir.
If you want to live for 100 years, plant a tree. If you want to live for posterity, raise a family. If you want to be remembered for eternity, teach a child the way he should go, so that when he is old, he will not depart from it, says the Bible. Thus, Mr. Wilfredo C. Aguila, Director for Administration, begins his tribute to the Faculty of Instruction, Office Staff, and Maintenance Personnel.
Good afternoon, everyone. Come to think of it, suddenly, like a whirlwind that strikes without warning, this pandemic just bolted from out of the blue. If there was a warning at all, it was feigned that it was not taken seriously. Hence, catching the country flat-footed. The economic and health managers were at a loss how to address the pandemic head-on. The education sector was not spared, Heroes College included, seriously affecting the administration, faculty and staff, as well as students and their parents. No one knew for sure how long will this pandemic would last. What was certain, though, was it created a pandemonium everywhere, especially in the education sector. Students in particular were so confused as to the continuity of their education. Teachers were likewise perplexed at the pronouncements of the government, and school administrations were aghast at how the emergency was handled. The Heroes administration, with its sheer guts for survival, adroitly employed effective measures to keep everyone afloat. It adopted viable measures to keep this community intact. Though it was quite uncomfortable, it took care of every member of the faculty, office staff, and maintenance personnel alike. While a bit of sacrifice was necessary from everyone, it was bearable. In the words of the administrative officer, and I quote, "We are all into this. Let us share with each other the pinch that this pandemic brings so that no one bears the whole pain alone," unquote. Yes, the pain becomes bearable since it is divided more or less equally, and no one bears the brunt by himself alone. And rightly so, almost everyone became resourceful with a ready response to the abnormal situation. Feeling ugly effect of the salary cap, almost everyone became instant businessmen, earning an honest extra peso to help make both ends meet. And this will all kept away from the knowledge of our students. Notwithstanding the struggles felt and the need to use technology in the classroom, in lieu of the face-to-face class instruction due to required protocol observance, we, members of the Faculty of Instruction, the office staff, maintenance personnel, took everything in stride. We eagerly submitted ourselves to learn new classroom techniques using technology. Those of us who are good in the trade willingly provided assistance to those in need to develop new skills. Speaking of collaboration, concern, and cooperation, this is it. Thus, the education of the innocent, which is entrusted to our care, was never compromised, nay, put into peril. If that is not heroes' personal resiliency, then I don't know what is. why don't we live more? Let us love more. Let us live better lives. For it is in loving that we live. It is in living better that we teach and work effectively, leaving a precious legacy to our students, to whom we dedicate our life, to whom we show our love, and to whom knowledge, understanding, and wisdom we impart. Let us always understand them and be more tolerant in their needs. In that way, we implant into their being that wisdom to realize the greatness of our work, our dedication to our calling, our passion for their own good, and our avowed mission for their own sake. Let us stand firm alongside the vision and goals of our college for this purpose. In doing so, we perpetuate the enduring legacy of the founders and pioneers who sought their fortune in this once a wilderness, yet hallowed grounds in the hinterlands of Balana. Led by the founders some 4 decades ago, these pioneers, our forebears, are teachers, office staff, maintenance personnel themselves, who left the comfort of their homes in the city and in faraway lands to seek fruition of their passion to help develop the youth into total person in this little part of the nation. The founders must be smiling sweetly with the thought that their pioneering efforts did not go to waste. Certainly, their enduring legacy deserves perpetuity. Let us then be grateful for this opportunity to help perpetuate that legacy. Let us take the humble pride in being active members of Team Heroes that see the same vision, share a common goal, undertake the same mission, and aim our rifle at the same target. Fellow workers, you have done a good job. You are doing a great job. You will do more in this, our job. My salute to all of you. Thank you, Lord God, for blessing us in our efforts. Good evening.
Thank you very much, Mr. Aguila, for a very inspiring and heartwarming tribute to our faculty and staff.
Our dear parents have labored their hands to help their children to obtain their respective degrees. With that, it is the time we all been waiting for, to pay tribute to them and recognize all their efforts and sacrifices. With the video that we have prepared for our dear parents, it is our sincere hope that they would feel the warmth of love and gratefulness of each and every graduate.
Thank you.
pledge of loyalty, let us have Mr. Joseph P. Jeronimo from BS Criminology.
I request all graduates to stand up for our pledge of loyalty. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name, Joseph Jeronimo, do solemnly pledge that I will be loyal and faithful to my alma mater, the Bataan Heroes College, to cherish her ideals, and uphold at all times her tradition of service to humanity. I pledge to work incessantly and devotedly to help secure a better and fuller life, not only for my family and for my community, but above all for my country and my God. To this I pledge with my name and honor, so help me God.
At this moment, Engineer Janet S. Crisostomo, an alumnus of Bataan Heroes College, who took up Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering, Batch 1995, who is now the current Dean of Department of Engineering and Architecture here in our campus, will induct the new graduates to the Alumni Association.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name, Janet S. Crisostomo. After having been declared as graduate, do hereby solemnly swear that I will maintain allegiance to my alma mater, the Bataan Heroes College. I promise that I will support and cherish the BHC Alumni Association, defend and obey its constitution and bylaws, respect and abide by the legal orders of duly constituted authorities thereon. I promise to practice my profession according to the best of my knowledge and discretion, guided by the highest standards of fidelity and efficiency, and that I impose upon myself these obligations willingly and voluntarily, without mental reservation or purpose of evasion. So help me God.
Thank you, Dean Crisostomo, for inducting the new graduates. With raised fists, let us sing the BHC hymn as our farewell tribute to our alma mater.
Sing and pledge loyal true friends, love, devotion, and faith. BHC renowned in manliness, holds our future and our fate. Voices echo in unison, all our hearts beat as one, singing together the same song. Ever grateful for all you have done. And to thee, our alma mater, hail, oh hail, we greet thee forevermore. We may cross the oceans and the hills while we travel, and treasure you from shore to shore. BHC, pride of our nation, sail on thy voyage, come and smooth. Dedication to our youth. Here to thee, our alma mater, hail, oh hail, we greet thee forevermore. We may cross the oceans and the hills while we travel, and treasure you from shore to shore. BHC, pride of our nation,
my voyage coming smooth. You are a dedication, dedication to our youth.
As a parting message, I would like to leave you a quote from Cory Booker. Real courage is holding on to a still voice in your head that says, I must keep going. It's that voice that says nothing is a failure if it is not final. That voice says to you, get out of bed, keep going, I will not quit. From the moment you call it's over, or you stop what you are doing, you also lose the opportunity to achieve triumph. Do not quit and fight for your dreams. The caller shall lead the processional march and the 41st commencement exercises in here by officially concluded. Thank you and good night.